Welcome to video lecture series in Sociology. Today we are going to discuss chapter 7 titled as Mass Media and Communications from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. We have already started discussing this chapter, which is divided into four parts. So far we have discussed about mass media and mass communication, understanding the basic concept of mass media, traditional and modern means of communication, features of mass media and mass communication, and about the digital divide. In this lecture, today we will start discussing about the functions of mass media, which happens to be the second part of this chapter. Look at the presence of media in your everyday life. It's immense. Across the world, large number of people or millions of people start their morning with newspapers. People switch on to the radio or TV sets to get latest update of your national and international events. Depending upon choices, people listen to soft music, devotional songs or popular programs related to yoga and art of living to start their mornings. People start contacting others on phone and plan their day and business accordingly. Since its emergence, different types of mass media in various ways has influenced variety of people in different ways. This influence has been different across different sections of society, depending upon age, educational level, class and interest of the people. For a long period of time, print media was only medium of mass communication. Electronic media, as a new forms of mass communication, is of recent origin. In fact, there are three important functions of mass media, both print and electronic. This is to inform, to entertain and to educate. News and discussions on TV and radio and newspaper and magazines all inform us. Radio and television programs on science, history, news, current events are educating in nature. Even newspapers educate you. Along with the function of providing information and education, the mass media is entertaining as well. A wide variety of programs such as music shows, cinema, serials, cartoon shows, sporting events like live matches, cricket, tennis, football, hockey are great source of entertainment. Being part of opening and closing ceremony of big sporting events like Olympics is no longer a dream. TV brings it directly to us in our drawing rooms. Media helps in dissemination of information through which it makes people aware of social, economic and political issues, and thus it acts as an agent of social change and development as well. Mass media has tremendous capacity to influence us, change and shape the nature and structure of societies, and it can be an important source, and it is in fact an important source for social change. As we have discussed about the functions of mass media, that it informs, educates and entertains. Along with this, mass media makes people aware about the lives of people in other societies. It gives people scope to compare themselves with the lives of the others. That helps them to assess where do they stand. We can take example of the Pulse Polio program that used media as a channel to generate awareness among people regarding the disease. The program was widely advertised on TV, in newspapers, on radio. Last year, not even a single case of polio was reported from India. Polio has almost been eradicated. As a source of information and education, media in this case has helped in making people aware of the disease. Media helps in self-assessment and critical evaluation also. How does it do? It helps us to know about other societies and cultures through various programs. Media in such cases can be an important medium to guide people and society towards positive change and development. Let us discuss about the impact of mass media on society. We will begin by looking at the positive impact or contributions of media on society. Two points we have already discussed. One is that media is an important source of news and information for the people. And secondly, media programs and packages educate public. The third is that media is also an important institution for democracy, for a healthy democracy. It is also known as the fourth estate. Media contributes to the effective functioning of a democratic society. It helps to inform general public about the programs and policies of the government. It provides an open and free platform to people to voice their opinion regarding the government and its policies. Thus, media helps as a useful link between the state and the citizen or the society. In the era of globalization, media has connected people from remote parts of the world into a single global community. In fact, it is media that has played a very crucial role in accelerating the pace of globalization. Related to globalization is the spread of global capitalism. Here again, in the spread of global capitalism, media is a channel through which various products are advertised, and consumerism at the global level is being promoted. Since the advent of electronic media such as radio, TV, the meaning, purpose and function of mass media has changed a lot. Along with its role to inform, entertain and educate people, media has now also got a major social responsibility. In fact, social responsibility is one of the most important functions of media nowadays. The advocates of normative view of the press or media, that is what media should do or ought to do, argue that the conduct of media has to take into account the public interest. The theory of social responsibility of media identifies certain basic principles, that is, what is the social responsibility of media or what it should do. These principles are, number one, that media ownership is a public trust and media has certain obligations towards the society. Second important principle is that news media should be fair, objective, relevant and truthful. The third is there should be freedom of the press, but there is also a need for self-regulation of media agencies. Fourth, media should adhere to the personal code of conduct and ethics, and government may have a role to play if under specific circumstances public interest is being hampered. While promoting public interest, the central concerns of mass media should take into account are freedom of publication, freedom of expression, plurality in media ownership, diversity in information, culture and opinion. There should be a support for public order and security of the state. Media has to have a universal reach. There has to be a quality of information disseminated to the public. The media should respect for human rights while promoting the public interest. It should observe privacy and media ethics and avoiding any harm to individuals and harmony of the society. Now, along with these positive roles and responsibility, media is also widely criticized for the negative impact on society and people. Let us look at the other side of the argument. Many people argue that exposure to programs and content of mass media, such as music, modern day films, from other society affects traditional cultures adversely. Young generation is progressively getting drawn towards the popular culture, particularly the Western culture, and traditional cultures are getting declined. It is also put forward that among the three important functions of media, that is to inform, educate and entertain, media now has primarily become a source of entertainment only, increasingly without any substance, and hence it is posing threat to our value system. Media is also blamed for promoting violence. Various studies have shown that violence shown on TV and cinema influences young and impressionable minds of the children negatively. Through advertising, media also promotes an unnecessary desire among people, particularly the young people, to consume more than they need or can afford. This drive is called as consumerism. What does consumerism mean? It converts the wants into needs and prompts consumption in society in general. People buy things that may not be useful or essential for them. While this may be good for the capitalist who makes profit out of it, but it also generates frustration among people when they are unable to meet their desires. Such frustrations in extreme cases become reasons for tensions in family and society. Such frustrations can also lead to crime and violence. You might have come across many examples of frauds being committed in order to look rich and affluent. You might have come across these instances in news where people have committed crimes to be part of a rich society. Another important aspect is that young children perform stunts and acts as shown on TV and in advertisements, thinking that they'll also become like the characters shown on the television. Many such cases have resulted in accidents and loss of life among these young children. As a student of sociology, you should try understanding the impact of media upon everyday life. In modern societies, media shapes people's perception. Its reach and impact is immense, and it is becoming deeper and wider day by day. Look at the instances and examples in daily life and try to identify that are they influenced by media? If yes, then how and to what extent? After discussing the role and impact of mass media, let's discuss rise of modern mass media. Modern mass media is a consequence of development in the field of science and technology in Europe, particularly after Industrial Revolution. The first commercial printing press was established in Britain. The technique of printing was developed by Jonathan Gutenberg, a German goldsmith, in 1440. After this, the printing technology quickly developed all over Europe. Printing helped massively in spreading modern ideas of enlightenment among people that led to transformation of European societies forever. Printing led to the evolution of different forms of channel of communication and spread of information through newspapers, books, pamphlets and magazines. It helped in producing large number of copies of these books and newspapers that were distributed among large number of people, and information was made available to thousands of people at the same time or simultaneously. Although initially printing was restricted to religious books, but with Industrial Revolution, the print industry grew. The initial products of printing were restricted to a limited audience because literate elite were few in number. There were two reasons for this. One is, as already discussed, because not many people were literate, and second, even printing was limited in terms of scale and investment. It required a kind of technical know-how. However, with the rise of rate of literacy among people and developments in the field of technology and transportation, newspapers began to reach out to a large number of people in different corners of Europe. Information and its influence started traveling long distances beyond the confines of city and state. Although the newspaper was developed around 17th century, but it took more than one century for it to take form of a mass media, to spread information and influence people at a large scale. Since 19th century then, there has been an increase in circulation of newspaper continuously. Print media gained popularity from the beginning of 20th century. Printing led to evolution of different forms of channel to communicate and spread information in the form of large number of printed material. This evolution in fact connected people together. People living in different parts of the country found themselves sharing the same information. The exchange of information not only led to increase in the levels of information, but it also generated a sentiment of bonding between people. People started knowing not only about how much they are different, but also how much they were similar to each other, what is common or shared by all of them. This, in a way, led to rise of feeling of belongingness among people. They felt connected to one another and saw themselves as part of a larger community. As Benedict Anderson suggests, the rise of the feeling of we or belongingness led to growth of nationalism. People who earlier did not know about each other's existence, after knowing it through media, started to feel like members of a large family, community or a nation, sharing or having something in common to cherish. Anderson calls this as the idea of a nation. Nation can be seen as an imagined community, where common factors such as language, culture, religion, dress, food habits bind people together. In fact, media played an important role in generating awareness about this commonality among people. Thus, along with information, education and entertainment, media also has the capacity to bind or bring people close by giving them common ground to share and express ideas. To conclude this lecture, let's summarize what we discussed today. We started our discussion with main functions of mass media, which is to inform, educate and entertain. We discussed about the positive and negative functions being played by media, or positive and negative impact of forms of media and communication on society. Towards the end, we discussed about the birth of modern mass media in Europe and its role and how it gradually spread all over the world. In the next part of this chapter, we'll discuss about the emergence of mass media in modern India under the British rule. Till then, You can enjoy reading this part of the chapter. Thank you.